Oxford's virtual learning environment, WebLearn, offers a range of tools to support teaching and learning activities in courses that blend face-to-face and online teaching and learning. A cross-departmental team from Oxford's Continued Professional Development Centre and the Department of Primary Care has implemented a comprehensive WebLearn environment for use across three programmes in the health sciences. Dr. Adrian Stokes explains how the systematic use of WebLearn has led to a sustainable and efficient framework for blended learning.
What we wanted to do was embed the use of WebLearn across a range of programmes to bring the most out of it, to try and get a situation where the whole was greater than the sum of its parts. We've got colleagues with a lot of flair and creativity, but the important thing was to try and capture that, make sure those colleagues could do interesting and exciting things, but also that their good practice was shared and that we had something that the students could engage with consistently rather than just encountering one or two areas of very exciting practice, but with other areas which were not operating that way. Well, a number of colleagues were already using WebLearn, so there was some momentum already in particular areas. Our department also had been making quite extensive use of Moodle, specifically for online courses, but also as in some courses as VLEs. So we made a strategic decision here to go with the centrally supported VLE, with the idea that if we want to engage a range of departments, we need to go for a tool and a platform that's going to be available to all of those departments, where we can draw on the central expertise in OUCS with a view to taking the long-term approach and trying to make sure that we'd be able to do things in a sustainable way. Selecting tools was a mixture of experience with tools amongst the colleagues who'd already using them, but then also amongst the students, the feedback that they'd given on the tools we were already using. But we also then went through some fairly formalised consensus exercises to try and analyse what we wanted to use the WebLearn for, what effects we wanted to achieve, and see which combinations of tools would work best to achieve those ends. We came up with two basic kinds of sites operating at different levels of generality. So we had course sites. So for example, if you've got an MSc, the course site would try to cover the overall course structure, signposting to general information elsewhere in the university on the student gateway and so on. So kind of a reference and orientating kind of source that would cover the whole of the programme, but not in great detail, not trying to provide detailed reading list about every component. So there's the course level sites, and then we'd have module level sites. So we're talking here about modularised courses. So all of the components of the course were associated with one or other named modules. And a typical module would have had three phases. An orientation phase, where students are prepared to engage with one another and with the academic content of the module, where they're not in Oxford. They could be anywhere in the world. Then an intensive residential week, when they're here on site, living in Oxford or close by, with a very intense timetable of face-to-face teaching, a range of seminars, lectures, practicals and so on. And then a follow-up period where people are doing further reading, assignment preparation and so on. So you see that the VLE is kind of the wraparound for the whole thing, managing an orientation phase as a repository for important items that come out of the week. So for example, student presentations and tutor presentations could be uploaded, some video material and so on, captured from that week, and then support for that follow-up phase with drafting, some interaction with other students and tutors. So the VLE is supporting that kind of three-phase approach to an intensive module. Well, we're talking here about master's level courses and where the engagement between tutors and students, and students and one another, is very, very precious, and the time is limited. These intensive weeks where people are here for 5 days and then they're going to be back. They could be in Australia, Hong Kong, anywhere in the world. So what we're trying to do is to make sure that during that precious time, the emphasis is on critical analysis, evaluation, kind of the more demanding academic and professional skills, rather than on information giving and rather than on getting to know one another. Inevitably, if people haven't met before, they're going to need to get to know one another face to face. But you can start that sense of belonging and trust through the preparatory stage, online engagement, people posting introductions, so people getting oriented to one another, looking at some of the content that tutors have made available. So by the time they get to the intensive kind of face-to-face week, they're ready to discuss with one another. They're ready to get into the meat of the topic, get into detail, be critical, analytical, rather than having to suddenly read stuff and knowledge before they can move to that other level. Obviously, there are other things that we would, enhancements in terms of useful reference sources and bringing all compiling material together and making things easily accessible. But in terms of learning and teaching at master's level, the important thing is to get the criticality and the evaluative aspects of the learning going quickly, so that they kind of hit the ground running with the day one of the intensive module, as well as being supported with ongoing work afterwards. Well, student feedback from our early attempts with VLEs was very important in deciding to go with the project in the first place, and to try and get these kind of benefits across a wider range of provision, and also make those benefits stronger by the fact that student engagement is reinforced with repeated kind of engagement with the course, rather than them finding one experience in one area of the course and then not being able to follow it up. It's very very early days. The new kind of cross-departmental work only started with this term, so it's a couple of months ago. But early signs are promising that we're getting even higher levels of participation in the online elements of the course, and students actually want more. So they're coming up with their own ideas and feeding into the process of choosing new tools and deciding what's best at module and course level. I think try to be clear about what you're trying to achieve, because otherwise you've got no idea whether you're making progress or not. Try and put a team together, because to do anything on any scale for students does require more than one person. And individuals who may have an awful lot of enthusiasm, if they're not supported, they may lose that enthusiasm. If you lose them from your team, you've lost your provision. So although you want to take that enthusiasm and capture it, you mustn't leave those people unsupported, or indeed just allow a lot of individuals to run away, because although they might all produce excellent material, that we won't get the maximum return from that if the students aren't engaging with things in a reasonably consistent way. It'll take time for them to kind of spot what's going on, and they'll then wonder, why is it working in this way in this part of the course and not like that in another part. So getting that team approach so that you can pull out what needs to be consistent and leave some room for creativity there, but within a framework. And get advice. Come and see people at OUCS who will always advise you and may have already encountered some of the problems you've encountered, be able to put you in touch with other people so you broaden your network to support what you're doing.